Dear students, now we will see factors affecting the location of industries. Okay, these factors that affect the industries, the location of industries, are classified into geographical factors and socio-economic factors. Again, these geographical factors and socio-economic factors are classified into various factors. Geographical factors, the first one is accessibility, second one is climate, third one is land, fourth one is geography, fifth transport, sixth market, seventh raw materials. Again, socio-economic factors are capital, communication, government policy and labor supply. Okay, you see, these factors or industries depend on all these factors, without which an industry cannot function. See here in your book, it is where the diagram is very well given that this is an industry and what are the factors that are mostly necessary. Okay, is it clear? Okay, now factors means what? Factors means what are the important elements, what are the important things that are necessary for the establishment of an industry. Okay, now let us see geographical factors. Okay, geographical factors, the first one is accessibility. Now accessibility means to reach an industry or industry should be accessible through different means. Okay, and this accessibility also carries in mind that in order to bring, in order to import what? Raw materials, we need certain ways. In order to export materials, goods, products, we need what? We need accessibility. Is it clear? Okay, once you read through, you will understand better. Okay, the second one is climate. Climate also is very much important for the establishment of industries. For example, if the climate is very hot, the workers may not be able to work the 8 hours in the industry. And again, if the climate is always rainy, the laborers, the workers won't be able to reach the industry in time. So this climate also affects very much, okay, to the industry. The third one is land. For example, large scale industries, big industries need huge area of land, which is not possible in mountainous areas. Okay, so land also is very much important for what? For the establishing an industry. Okay, now to establish an industry, for example automobile industry, it requires a huge plot of land, and then what we call flat land, plain land is mostly accepted. Okay, next one is power. Okay, power supply also is very much important. Okay, there can be different sources of power. For example, water source, water power, and then also what? Steam power. Today in most of the industries, electric power is being used, but in earlier days, water power and steam power was used. Okay, this creates what? Power creates what? Creates energy, and through and with the help of this energy, industries function or industries run. Next one is transport. Without transport system, an industry cannot function, because transport system helps materials to be brought, and it helps the finished products, goods, to be exported in other areas. And if the transport is not proper, what will happen? Industries cannot function in time. Okay, mostly industries are located mostly near railway junctions. Why? Because it makes the transport system easy. When the train stops, where the train stops, what happens? We can unload the raw materials, we can load finished goods. Okay, so what happens? Railway junctions are considered, what is considered, to be the most suitable place, sites for the localization or establishment of industries. Then market. It is not enough to bring raw materials and produce goods. There should be also market for selling the finished products. Okay? So market also is an important factor for what? For the establishment of industries. And then the last one is raw materials. Raw materials should be available in that particular place. See, for example, in Assam we don't have jute industries, whereas in West Bengal they have jute industries. Why? Because in West Bengal jute is available, whereas in Assam jute is not. If they make or if they establish jute industry in Tangla, for example, what will happen? They have to import raw materials from West Bengal, and this will cost huge amount. But here we are very familiar with tea industries. Why? Because the raw materials, the product, not product, we call materials that are necessary to run tea industries, easily available here. But in Rajasthan we don't find tea industries. Why? Because the raw materials are not available there. Is it clear? Okay. Now we will see socio-economic factors. Socio-economic factors, the first one is capital. To establish an industry, we need a huge amount of capital. Okay? Without the investment of huge amount of capital, establishment of industry is not possible. Therefore, companies cannot set up their industries if they do not have capital. So in this case, to establish industries, we also can take loan from the government, from different finance banks. Okay. Second one is communication. Communication also is very, very much important. We should have what? We should have different means of communication. Telephone line should be there, internet should be there, okay? Fax should be there, phone facility should be there, and so on. And then government policy. So governments can greatly influence the location of industries by providing what? Tax incentives. Incentives means they can cut down what? Tax from certain industries in order to uplift the industry. Okay? And then cheap rent and other benefits. Cheap, they can give a big huge house with less price in order to support them. And by this support, what happens? What happens? The government also helps in running or in the improvement of the people there living. Because once an industry is made, development is no doubt. Development takes place. So government makes different policies in order to improve the industries. Okay. Then the last one is labor supply. Of course, modern technologies are used in industries, but without the help of labor, without the help of human energy, an industry cannot run. Okay? Therefore, what I am saying is, here, labor supply, that means what? For example, in sugar industry, tea industries, all the works are not carried out by human beings. Therefore, labor supply is very much important. So if, for example, if an industry is established in a place where there are no laborers, will the industry be able to function? No. So what happens? Labor supply is also very much important for the functioning of an industry. Okay. Dear students, now we shall see major industries of the world. Okay. There are so many industries all over the world. We are not going to see everything, but the major industries of the world. Okay. Without which, why they have given major industries of the world? Because without these industries, other industries can't function. Okay. The major industries of the world are iron and steel industry, cotton textile industry, information industry, technology, sugar industry, shipbuilding industry, and fishing industry. Okay. So let us see firstly. What we shall see? Firstly, we shall see iron and steel industry. Okay. Steel is major industry of all countries. Keep in mind, iron and steel industry is major industry of all the countries. It is used as what? It is used as raw materials for other industries. Major steel industries are located in countries like Germany, USA, China, Japan, India, Brazil, and Russia. Okay. Raw materials such as iron ore, coal and limestone, together with labor, capital, location and other infrastructure, are important inputs of this industry. Okay. So this is all about iron and steel industry. Again, another point to be kept in mind is that India is now, at present, India is the third largest producer of steel in the world. After what? After China and Japan. That means China is the first, Japan is second, and India is the third. Okay, major industries located, major iron and steel industries located in India. Where do we find iron and steel industry in India? Okay, we find where? In Barnapur, in Durgapur, in Barnapur and Durgapur in West Bengal. In West Bengal, there is a place called Barnapur and Durgapur. Okay. Then Bokaro and Jamshedpur in Jharkhand, Bhilai in Chhattisgarh, and Rourkela in Odisha. So these are the places where iron and steel industries are located in India. Keep this in mind. Second one is cotton textile industry. Okay. The cotton textile industry is one of the oldest among all manufacturing industries. Okay. This cotton textile industry is one of the oldest industries, manufacturing industries. Signs of the existence of cotton textile industry can be observed in all the early civilizations like Indus Valley, ancient Egypt, the Vedic period, and Roman Empire. At present, the major textile industries are concentrated in India. In India, the major textile industries are established or concentrated. China and USA. In India, the first textile mills were established at Fort Gold Star near Kolkata. Underline this line. Okay. The first textile mill in India was established in a place called what? Fort Gold Star near Kolkata in 1818. Keep this in mind. The first successful modern textile mill, that was Alden. Okay. Modern textile mill was established in Mumbai in 1853. This also you have to keep in mind. Okay. Another point to be kept in mind is the port city of Osaka, that is in Japan. Okay. Port city of Osaka is the hub of the textile industry in Japan. Or a question may arise here, which city is known as the hub of textile industry in Japan. You have to name the city. Other important countries include China, USA, Germany, Brazil, Egypt and Pakistan for the production in cotton textile industries. Okay. Next one is information technology, or we call it IT industry. Okay. So information technology industry deals in the storage, processing and distribution of information. They store information. Okay, IT industries. So this is global industry, not an industry based only for a country. This is a global industry. Okay. The major hubs of IT industry in the world are the Silicon Valley in California, USA. Keep this in mind. Silicon Valley in California, USA, and Bengaluru in India, also called the Silicon Valley of India. Okay. Next one is sugar industry. Okay, sugar industry. Sugar is an important commercial crop worldwide, without which life becomes very difficult. Can you drink tea without sugar? No. Okay. So this becomes what? Very important commercial crop all over the world, not in India, not in China, not in US alone, but all over the world. And is one of the principal source of sugar, ethanol and jaggery. Okay. It's byproducts. See, from sugar we can't only produce sugars, but the byproducts are used as fodder to feed what? Livestock in many countries. They are not just thrown away. Major sugarcane producers in the world are USA, Indonesia, Colombia, Pakistan, Mexico, Brazil, India, China and Thailand. Keep this in mind. Okay, then another industry, that is automobile industry. Okay, automobile industry. Or the world's automobile industry includes the manufacturing, processing and sale of all the vehicles such as cars, vans, trucks and buses. This automobile industry helps the other industries to function, because without vehicles, without trucks, sugar cane cannot be transported to sugar industry. And if sugar cane cannot be transported, can sugar industry function? No. Therefore, automobile industry is helping the other industries to run. Okay. These vehicles are essential for the smooth working of global economy, as other industries depend heavily on the automobile industry. See, other industries depend what? Heavily on automobile industries. Okay, for variety of services, for transportation purposes, to bring the laborers, to drop by the laborers and so on. Okay, some of the major automobile producing countries are China, USA, Japan, Germany, South Korea, Spain, Brazil and Canada. Okay, next one is shipbuilding industry. Shipbuilding industry. So shipbuilding industries are the industries which construct water vessels such as ships, ocean liners and tankers. Okay, these industries are usually located where? At the harbor, in the seaports. Okay, that have large spaces. These industries cannot be located in small areas. It needs a huge space. The practice of shipbuilding began in the ancient civilization, where people used rivers for transportation. Okay, in the ancient civilization, people moved from one place to another place using the waterways. So to move in the waterways, they need what? They need ships. So slowly the shipbuilding industries developed. After the Second World War, the industry grew larger. It became famous and gained prominence, became very, very important for every country to have shipbuilding industry. Okay, then the world's largest shipbuilding industry is located where? In China, followed by Japan and South Korea. Other important shipbuilding countries include Germany, France, India, USA and Netherlands, Brazil, European and Sweden. In India, the major shipbuilding industries are located where? In Visakhapatnam, that is in Andhra Pradesh, Calcutta in West Bengal, Kochi in Kerala and Bombay in Maharashtra. Okay, keep this in mind. Major shipbuilding industries located in India, where? Visakhapatnam, Calcutta, Kochi and Bombay. Okay, then the last one is fishing industry. Fishing industry includes all the activities, okay, where fish or fish products are gathered, processed, preserved. Processed means they do different activities with the fish. Preserved, they keep it, store it and transport it. Okay, transport, marketed or sold is termed as fishing industry. Okay, all these activities including that is related to fish is known as fishing industry. Okay, the aim of this industry is to uplift the economy of the country. Okay, see here, fishing is an important source of food in islands. Island countries like Japan, Iceland and countries of the Caribbean. Countries like Chile and Peru have long coastlines, and thus this fishing industries, fish is the major source of economy. Okay, but we shall not consider that fishing industry, since fishing industry is established, we shall finish up the industries. This may create what? This may create imbalance in the ecosystem. So there should be the conservation of fish as well as. Okay, keep this in mind. Therefore what? Protection and conservation of fish are very, very important. Now the major countries that have fishing industries are what? China, Japan, Peru, Chile, USA, Thailand, India, Norway, Indonesia, Russia and Iceland are the major fish producing countries in the world. Okay, why they are major fish producing countries in the world? Because these countries are just located near the sea and ocean, and therefore they can easily get access to the fishing.